everyone. I'm Roy Disney, and what better place to start an exploration of animals than the remarkable Tree of Life at Disney's Animal Kingdom. This 14-story wonder is carved with images of more than 300 different animals and celebrates, in a monumental style, the circle of life theme that defines the Lion King. And each of these animals is a story in itself. In fact, everything at Disney's Animal Kingdom has to do with animals, real, extinct, and even imaginary. So let's use this as a starting point to take a closer look at the characters of the Lion King and see the real creatures that inspired them.
A king's time as ruler rises and falls like the sun. One day, Simba, the sun will set on my time here and will rise with you as the new king.
He's the future king?
Yeah, so you have to do what I tell you.
To be a king, you need a kingdom, of course. And in Africa, a lion's kingdom consists of grassy plains and open woodlands called savannas.
I'm gonna be the main event, like no king was before.
Just like Simba and his family, lions live in groups called prides. And there could be as many as 35 lions in one pride. Each pride has a leader, like Mufasa. This ruler patrols the pride's territory and chases off any unwanted visitors.
I just can't wait to be king.
By a show of brute strength and an awesome roar that can be heard for 5 miles.
That was it? Do it again.
So what's a typical meal for a grown-up lion? How about 15 pounds of meat?
I'm so hungry I could eat a whole zebra.
Yes, it takes plenty of prey to feed every lion in a pride. But like Simba's mother, Sarabi, and Simba's pal, Nala, it's the female lions that bring home the bacon. And when the work is done, lions can be found, well, lying around. Some lions spend up to 20 hours a day resting and taking cat naps. Now, even though each pride has a leader, the ruling male can sometimes feel threatened by a younger male in the group.
Run away and never return.
It's a constant battle to stay on top, so the ruler often drives young lions out of the pride. But, like Simba returning to Pride Rock to fight Scar, young lions sometimes return when fully grown to try and take over. Growing up for a young male lion also includes growing a mane. They're the only big cats that have them.
Mom, you're messing up my mane.
A thick, bushy mane makes a male lion look big and strong. Just one more reason the lion is called the King of Beasts. If you're a fan of Timon, then you already know that Timon is a meerkat. But did you know that meerkats are not cats at all?
Whoa! Time out! Let me get this straight.
They belong to the weasel or mongoose family. And even though Timon hangs out with Pumbaa most of the time, real meerkats stick with their own kind in groups of 5 to 30 members.
You know her. She knows you.
These groups are called mobs, or gangs, but there's no ties to the mafia, to anyone's knowledge.
Ew, what's that?
A grub. What's it look like?
Like Timon, Insects are one of the meerkat's favorite foods.
Tastes like chicken.
But they also snack on lizards and small animals.
These are rare delicacies.
Pecans with a very pleasant crunch.
They dig for their dinner among roots and under stones.
This is the great life. No rules, no responsibilities. Ooh, the little cream film kind.
These fast-moving critters live in underground burrows on the African plains that they dig themselves. They use their long black claws as digging tools. In fact, these little guys can dig their own body weight in dirt in just a few seconds. The dark markings around the meerkat's eyes act as built-in sunglasses, shading their eyes from the bright African sun. And their ear openings close to keep out dirt and dust, since, as you can see, there's constant digging going on around them. The meerkat uses his long tail to help him stand upright. And he is one of only a few animals that can stand up like humans can. A meerkat spends most of his time eating, sunbathing, grooming, and sleeping. Does that sound like someone we know?
Wow! If you're hungry for a hunk of fat and juicy meat, eat my buddy Pumba here, because he has a treat. Coming down a dine on a tasty swine, all you have to do is get in line. Ah, you aching?
Yup, yup, yup.
For some bacon?
Yup, yup, yup.
He's a big pig.
Yup, yup.
You can be a big pig, too. When he was a young warthog.
When I was a young warthog!
Warthogs are wild pigs who get their name from the wart-like bumps on their faces. Their eyes sit high on their heads to help them see into the distance, where a hungry predator might be waiting.
She's gonna eat me! Run, Pumba, move it!
Slimy yet satisfying.
Just like Pumba, warthogs love to eat grubs, but their main diet is wet grass.
Kid, what's eating you?
Nothing. He's at the top of the food chain. The food chain!
Warthogs mow through the grass like power lawnmowers, snipping plants with their sharp front teeth.
I'm stumped!
And to make their whole dining experience a little easier, warthogs kneel down on their padded front legs to get closer to their food. A warthog's snout acts like a built-in shovel, making them extremely good diggers. But rather than build their own underground homes, warthogs usually move into an aardvark's burrow once he's abandoned it. Like most pigs, warthogs love a good mud bath. Oh yeah, it washes away parasites and helps them stay cool when the weather heats up.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Warthogs usually live in groups called sounders, but adult males prefer to go it alone, like Pumba.
What's wrong with that?
Unfortunately for warthogs, they're a favorite food of lions.
Oh.
But even the king and queen of beasts fear the warthog's sharp, pointy tusks. Just like Pumba when he battled the hyenas, warthogs can be fierce fighters.
Who's the pig?
Are you talking to me?
Uh-oh, they call him the pig.
Are you talking to me?
Shouldn't have done that.
Are you talking to me?
Now they're in for it.
Hey, call me Mr. Pig!
Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna
Matata.
These plump animals are surprisingly light on their feet, and they bounce along happily with their tails straight up in the air, just like someone we all know and love.
hyenas. I hate hyenas.
Hyenas look somewhat like dogs, but they would make lousy pets. For one thing, their powerful jaws can chew up just about anything, including large bones.
Hey, did we order this dinner to go?
Imagine what they do to your house slippers.
We'd love you to stick around for dinner.
Hyenas are so ferocious, they even attack each other.
Will you knock it off?
Well, he started it.
Hyenas come in two types, spotted and striped.
Even you can't be caught unawares.
Oh!
The spotted hyena is larger and has reddish fur with a sloping back. Striped hyenas are gray with black stripes and pointed ears.
And man, are they ugly!
But you'll probably only see them at night, since they're nocturnal.
Boo!
Just like lions, hyenas hunt in packs, and the females do the majority of the work. Despite their appearance, hyenas are fast runners, reaching speeds up to 40 miles per hour. Very few animals can outrun the hyena.
You told me they're nothing but slobbering, mangy, stupid vultures.
Ixnay on the oopitsday.
Who you calling oopitsday?
They are therefore excellent hunters. So good, in fact, the lions, who hang out nearby, often want to muscle in on their meals. A hyena's howl sounds a lot like laughter. But believe me, the appearance of a hyena is no laughing matter.
Not the birdie boiler!
Hey, why don't you pick on somebody your own size?
Like you? Oops.
Yes, our teeth and ambitions are red. Be prepared.
The Lion King continues a long tradition of Disney's relationship with the animal kingdom. In fact, my dad once told me that after a particularly unpleasant meeting with a difficult colleague, he heard his brother Walt mutter, "Sometimes I prefer animals to people."
Disney and animals. In so many ways, the story of Disney is the story of animals of many different kinds. Walt often said of the studio that this all started with a mouse, and we still love that little fellow today.
Well, hello to Mr. Aylesworth, Mickey.
Hello, Mr. Aylesworth. How are you?
Mickey and his friends comprised Disney's first animal kingdom. With the success of the short cartoons, most of them starring animal characters, Walt inspired his artists to make their drawings of animals better and more realistic with every film.
It's always a challenge bringing a great story classic to the screen, giving visual form to characters and places that have only existed in the imagination.
To create Bambi, the studio brought in live animals for the artist to sketch. Not only to create believable animal movement, but to study their behavior and personalities. This tradition has continued through the years, and if you see an animated film that features animals, from Lady and the Tramp to 101 Dalmatians to The Lion King, chances are the artists were inspired in creating their characters by their real-life counterparts. Disney's next animal adventure happened almost by accident, as an offshoot of a planned film about Alaska. Filmed by Al and Alma Malott, Seal Island created a completely new kind of movie, the nature film, which Walt dubbed The True Life Adventures. In Seal Island and the films that followed, the realism of nature was combined with an entertaining and often humorous storyline which attracted audiences of all ages. Seal Island won the Academy Award for Best Short Subject of the Year, successfully launching a series of 6 more featurettes and 6 full-length features that would continue for the next 12 years, and win 8 more Academy Awards. When planning Disneyland, Walt even dubbed one of its regions True Life Adventureland, later shortened to Adventureland, to feature wild animals.
Of course, to stock Adventureland with live animals was neither safe nor practical. So on paper, we began to sketch and design replicas that would be made of plastic and steel, but when in action, would be as lifelike as their real counterparts.
Over the years, everything from hippos and giraffes to extinct species of dinosaurs to fantasy creatures like a fire-breathing dragon were crafted to stand in for their storybook originals. Animals continued to star in Disney live-action films, too. The True Life Adventures led to a series of wonderful stories that featured animals as their stars. Old Yeller, Savage Sam, and Big Red all featured four-legged stars, as well as the typical two-legged kind. Other films included The Bears and I and King of the Grizzlies, just to name a few. Fantastic animals were a staple of Disney, too. There was the boy magically transformed into a sheepdog in The Shaggy Dog, a Siamese cat spy in That Darned Cat, a mule who kicked field goals in Gus, and there was even a cat from outer space. A few years back, 4 new True Life Adventures premiered to great acclaim. Disney is always working on the next great animal project. For example, an epic journey of an unlikely pair of bears.
And my personal favorite Disney animal attraction premiered a few years back right here at Walt Disney World, called, appropriately enough, Disney's Animal Kingdom. This amazing realm guarantees that visitors will be able to continue to enjoy the long-standing union of the worlds of Disney nature, fantasy, and animals for generations to come.
So, I'll be seeing you.